That's right. Thank you. Sam, did Jesus abolish the law of Moses?
No, he didn't abolish it, because our Lord says in Matthew 5, 17, 18, he didn't come to abolish but fulfill. But what does it mean to fulfill? See, that's the real question. Fulfillment doesn't simply mean that Jesus came to obey the commands as given by Moses. I'm not saying he broke those commands. What I'm saying is fulfillment has a much deeper, richer meaning in the context of the scriptures. Mm-hmm. By fulfilling, Jesus meant he came to do all that the law and the prophets said Messiah would do. And he also came to perfect and complete the very spirit and essence of the law and the prophets. That's why if you read Matthew 5, where he says, "Think not I've come to abolish the law. I did not come to abolish but fulfill." He explains what he means. He brings out the true essence, this true spirit of the law. For example, it says, you have been told that you shouldn't murder someone. But I tell you that if someone has hate in his heart towards his brother, he has murdered him. So notice what he's doing here. He's bringing out the very essence and the heart of what the law and the prophets truly mean. And so it's his fulfillment of the law in the sense of his interpretation of what the law and the prophets mean and his fulfilling all the promises that point to him. So he didn't abolish, he fulfilled. But fulfilling means more than just obeying. Fulfilling means that he completes it because it all points to him. He fulfills all the promises because all the promises are yes and amen in him. And he brings out the true meaning of the law and the prophets.
Thanks, Sam.